In this tutorial, we will navigate through the licensing process for FME Server 2016. Before we begin, let's take a look at a few of the new licensing features that can be found in this year's release. We have simplified FME Server licensing so that it no longer relies on third-party licensing technology. Distributed or fault-tolerant distributions will now work with no further action required by the user. And machine keys are no longer tied to a MAC address or other similar specifics. This means it will now be compatible with a virtual machine, Docker, or other related technologies. Now that we have learned some of the updates, let's get started with the licensing process. After installing FME Server on your machine, go to the Windows Start menu and click on FME Server Web Interface. Log in with the administrator username and password specified during the installation. You will be prompted with a dialog window asking you if you would like to activate FME Server. Click on Yes. You should now be on the Engines and Licensing page, which indicates that FME Server is currently unlicensed. Let's go ahead and fix that. To request a new license, click on the Request License button. For the purpose of this demonstration, we will select Yes for the option Use Automatic Licensing via the Internet. This means that FME Server will simply obtain a license from our servers without the need for human intervention. Alternatively, if you are in a situation where you are disconnected from the Internet, or if the automatic option has not worked for you, then you may select the manual option. In order to license FME Server, we are also required to enter our credentials, such as email address, first name, and last name. Notice that the machine key field is already populated, and so no further action is required there. If you have already purchased FME Server, then you should have received a valid serial number for your asset. You may enter your unique serial number in the appropriate field before clicking OK. Following this, you would be prompted of your successful licensing, and the details of your specific asset would also be visible on the page. For the purpose of this demo, I will be using the evaluation method. I will leave the serial number field empty and will simply click OK. You should now see a dialog that will indicate the progress of your server licensing before showing that your license request was successful and that you now have a license installed. Below this dialog, we can now see the FME Server status has changed from unlicensed to a green checkmark. We can view further details to our installation, such as the number of engines licensed on the machine, the specific machine key, and for those of you who entered a valued serial number, this is where that information would be reflected. We also see the expiration date of the license. Notice that the evaluation license has provided me with a 7-day trial period. If I go to the inbox of the email address I used for the license registration, then I will see an email waiting for me from codes@safe.com. This message confirms my evaluation and the 7-day trial period that I have been granted. However, you will also notice that if you wish to do so, you may obtain a 60-day FME Server license. If you wish to extend your evaluation period, then click on the link provided. By clicking on this link, you will validate your email address and be notified that your request was successfully submitted. Back in FME Server, on the same Engines and Licensing page, you can click on the Refresh License button. Again, we will see the dialog indicating that our license request is being processed. This time, after the successful license prompt is achieved, we can see that our expiration date has refreshed to provide us with an extended evaluation of FME Server.